Senior Nick Daniels scored the final 5 points of the night as the IPFW Mastodons came into the Vidala Bean Center and assured that December would start just the way November ended for the SIUE men's basketball team. They fall in a close one. Final score 69-64 here at the Vidala Bean Center. I'm Joe Pott. This is another Cougar All Access. As I said, it was a tough night here for the Cougars. They dropped to 0-6 with the loss at the hands of IPFW. Head coach Lennox Forrester.
You know, another close one that we just didn't, you know, make the plays down the stretch, you know, coming up with offensive board or defensive rebounds. And again, you know, making free throws again down the stretch, I thought. So, you know, but, you know, we're knocking on the door and just got to keep our guys' heads up and just keep plugging along, keep playing hard, keep practicing hard, keep paying attention to details, and, you know, hopefully we can get it going here. Right now we are giving ourselves a chance to win down the stretch, but again, we got to be a team that now start making the tough plays, you know, down the stretch to win games. So, you know, we're getting there. We're getting there. But it's you know, like I told our guys before this game, hey, it's time to start winning some and quit being close and all that. But it's time to start winning some. So hopefully, you know, we can do that here pretty soon.
Sophomore Mark Yelovich paced the Cougars for the second game in a row. He scored 15, also had a team-high 8 rebounds. It was the sophomore David Borden that provided a spark off the bench. 25 minutes of work, he added 11 points. Senior Amir McCleary added 14 for the Cougars, but they come up short 69-64 to IPFW. They'll travel to Des Moines, Iowa on Friday to take on the Drake Bulldogs of the Missouri Valley Conference. That's round one of the Drake High V Tournament Challenge. On Saturday, they'll take on either North Dakota or UT Arlington. I'm Joe Pott. That's another Cougar All Access.